Today's topic is floodlighting, and what is meant by floodlighting? An artificial light, so directed or diffused, as to give a comparatively uniform illumination over a large given area is known as floodlighting. Floodlights are broad beamed, high intensity artificial lights. They are often used to illuminate outdoor playing fields while an outdoor sport event is being held during low light condition. More focused kinds are often used as a stage lighting instrument in live performances such as concerts and plays. Floodlighting is the use of high powered light bulbs to illuminate a large outdoor space. It is very common to use floodlight to enhance the architectural features of a historical or impressive building. The use of floodlights enhance the details of the building. The dimension of the building determines the physical size of the lighting unit. To illuminate a very tall building, the lighting unit must be large enough to project the level of light required. In general, the unit should be placed at least 75% of the building height away from the base of the building. Sign lighting often requires more than one floodlight. These units should be installed equidistant from each other and centered on the sign. A standard rule of thumb is that the light should be less than half the distance from the base of the sign apart from each other. General area lighting is used for security and sporting events. These lights are usually installed on the top of very tall poles to illuminate a large area. Now we'll see the important terms in floodlighting. Number one, beam angle. The angle within which the diversity of illumination produced on a surface at right angle to the beam does not exceed 10 to 1. For symmetric floodlights, there will be two beam angles, one in elevation and the other in azimuth. The second term is beam lumens. The luminous flux contained within the beam as defined in beam angle. It is usually taken as 25 to 30% of the lamp lumens, from which we can calculate the number of floodlights required. Number of floodlights required is equal to average illumination into area divided by beam lumens. The third term is waste light factor. When several floodlights are illuminating a surface, there is certain light of waste. Some amount of overlap and some of the light fall beyond the edges of the area to be illuminated. For rectangular area, waste light factor value is 1.2. For irregular area, such as monuments and statues, its value is 1.5. The fourth term is depreciation factor. Due to dirt and dust on projector surface, the effectiveness of the projector reduces from 50 to 100%, and hence more light should be provided than is theoretically required. Floodlighting calculation. Step 1. We have to find illumination level required. It depends upon the building, the purpose of floodlighting. Step 2. Selection of projectors. The projectors are classified as, number 1, narrow beam projectors with the beam spread angle between 12 and 25, usually distance beyond 70 meter. Number 2, medium angle projectors with the beam spread angle, that is 25 and between 25 and 40 degree, distance between 30 to 70 meters. The third is wide angle projectors with the beam spread angle between 40 and 90 degree below 30 meters. Step 3, we have to calculate number of projector required is obtained from the following relation. N is equal to number of projector, that is equal to area to be illuminated A into illumination E into depreciation factor into waste light factor divided by beam factor into wattage of lamp into luminous efficacy of the lamp. That is the formula for computing number of projectors. The front of a building 50 meter by 25 meter is illuminated by 25,000 watt lamps arranged so that uniform illumination on the surface is obtained. Assuming a luminous efficacy of 80 lumens per watt, coefficient of utilization is equal to 0.4, waste light factor is equal to 1.2, and depreciation factor is equal to 1.3. Determine the illumination on the surface. In this problem, the given values are: front area of a building is given, that is 15 meter by 25 meter. Number of lamps are given 25. Wattage of each lamp is given 1000 watts. Luminous efficiency of lamp is equal to 80 lumens per watt. And coefficient of utilization is equal to 0.4. Waste light factor is equal to 1.2. Depreciation factor is equal to 1.3. We have to find the illumination on the surface. And we know the formula N, that is N is the number of lamps, that is equal to A, area to be illuminated, E, illumination required, that is waste light factor, WLF, into depreciation factor divided by utilization factor into wattage of lamp into luminous efficacy. We know all the values. Area is equal to 50 into 25, that is equal to 1250 meter square. So we substitute all the values, find E is equal to 92.30 lumens per meter square. Therefore, illumination on the front area of the building is equal to 92.30 lumens per meter square or lux. The second problem is the front of a building 100 meter by 15 meter is to be illuminated by 1000 watt lamp. Find the number of lamp projectors required. Assume waste light factor is equal to 1.2, utilization factor is equal to 0.2, depreciation factor is equal to 1.3, luminous efficacy of 1000 watts lamp is equal to 80 lumens per watt. So in this problem, the wattage of lamp is given 1000 watts and area to be illuminated is given 100 meter by 15 meter and illumination E is given 100 lumens per meter square. Utilization factor is equal to 0.2, waste light factor is equal to 1.2, depreciation factor is equal to 1.3, luminous efficacy of 1000 watt lamp is equal to 18 lumens per watt. And we know the formula N, number of projectors required, or number of lamp required. N is equal to A, area to be illuminated, and E is the illumination, that is 100, and A is 100 into 15, that is 1500. Waste light factor is given as 1.2, depreciation factor is equal to 1.3, utilization factor is equal to 0.2, wattage of lamp is given 1000, luminous efficiency is 18. We substitute all the values in this formula. We find number of floodlight projectors required is equal to 65. It's a very simple problem. Thank you.